You can't be the boogeyman if I'm chasing
guy.
You.
Everyone knows I'm that guy, man.
You're not that guy.
I'm that guy.
Numbers don't lie, and I'm the number.
I'm that guy.
You're not the number guy. Yeah, numbers don't lie.
Let me play it one more time for the fools. Hold on.
Boogeyman. I am the boogeyman.
What is next for Terry?
No, I am the boogeyman. I am the boogeyman. I am the boogeyman.
No.
I'm the boogeyman.
It can't be the boogeyman.
I'm the dog of the division.
If I'm chasing him.
I'm the dog of the division. I'm the boogeyman.
You can't be the boogeyman if I'm chasing you.
Everyone knows I'm that guy.
What's happening, y'all? As y'all come into the video, y'all smash that like button, subscribe to the channel if you ain't subscribed already, man. We gotta get in this shit, man, because this is some real shit, man. That's going on these boxing streets, man. Terrence Crawford came out the other day and said, hey, man, I'll take motherfucking 65-35. I'll take the 35 from Errol Spence, nigga. I want to be mandatory for the IBF. I'm trying to see something. So, you know, Jaron Ennis came out, said, Jaron Ennis strength and conditioning coach who already been hating, but that's another story. His strength and conditioning coach came out, threw a little slick shot at Blu-ray, and he said that Jaron Ennis will break Errol Spence's face. Jaron Ennis came out himself and said, man, Errol Spence gotta vacate that motherfucking belt. Or fight me, or come get this smoke, or whatever the fuck he said, right? And then we got the fans coming out here, right? You know, Errol Spence ain't really been in niggas' face lately, so it's a lot of guys showing their true colors and they shifting different type of ways. You know what I'm saying? They trying to jump on the next nigga who give money, dig, or however you want to look at this shit. But what I say is, Errol Spence ain't never ducked no smoke. Ever, nigga. I never seen that nigga duck no smoke. No action. Any nigga want to fight, he down fight. Any nigga talking shit, he letting it be known. But right now, Errol Spence ain't saying shit. I'm going to tell you niggas what's going on, man. Because I be having to come out and do these videos, you know what I'm saying? That's why I gotta stay around all the time, because a lot of niggas started losing their mind and shit when I disappeared for like a day. Niggas start losing their motherfucking marbles. Niggas making videos saying all type of dumb shit. So I gotta come out and fix some of this shit that's going on, man. Errol Spence ain't never dug no smoke, nigga. And obviously, Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford is in negotiations. That's how I see it. Terrence Crawford said he taking 35. Nigga, why the fuck you ain't been saying that shit, nigga? He flexing because Errol Spence ain't saying shit right now. So he doing his little hype thing right now to keep niggas hype. Keep his fans hype. His side of the fence. I mean, not his side of the fence, because he ain't on this side no more. But he keeping his fan base, you know, keeping them hype right now by saying the little shit that he's saying. But how I don't look at it like shit. Him saying what the fuck? Do that mean he want to fight more than he wanted before or some shit? Like, nigga, that shit don't mean shit. The fuck? Talk about he want 35. Nigga, shut the fuck up, man. Knowing damn well your ass ain't gonna take no motherfucking 35. But if we really, really broke them fucking numbers down, you know what I'm saying? If you really, really broke them numbers down, fuck around, be 30% or something, 73%. But obviously, Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford in negotiations right now. You know what I'm saying? They in negotiations because Errol Spence is trying to make some shit happen. You know what I'm saying? Jaron Ennis want to smoke, but I really don't even give a fuck who want to smoke. I say this. Fuck it, let's get it then. You know what I'm saying? I really feel like Jaron Ennis missing like an opponent too. He should be fighting before he get the Errol Spence fight. But get that nigga to smoke, man. Fuck it, nigga. Niggas want to talk shit. Niggas want to say this and say that, trying to play on the nigga like he weak or something. And the nigga ain't never duck no action, bro. Nigga ain't never duck no smoke. But after Bud get this smoke, get his ass beat, Jaron Ennis gonna get your ass in the ring, man. Because Ugas in, he in a whole nother little situation, man. They got this man in a motherfucking terminal, man. That's some bullshit, but that's another story too. But if Jaron Ennis wanted that smoke, man, we get Jaron Ennis that smoke too. I really wanted him to finish building his name or some shit like that. Not even build his name, just fight like a name. Fight another, you know what I'm saying? Fight the next name until you get to the guy. You know, I look at this shit like King of the Hill. I wanted him to fight like the next guy, but somebody like Jose Lopez or somebody else, you know what I'm saying? But it is what it is, man. Niggas talking too much shit for me. I'm ready to see niggas get their ass beat now. You know what I'm saying? Cause fuck this shit, nigga. Cause they playing on the nigga like he really scared of a nigga who doing shit like this. I ain't never seen this nigga scared of nobody. This is the same nigga I seen.
You're not that guy. I'm that guy.
Numbers don't lie, and I'm the number.
I'm that guy.
You're not the number guy.
Man, he in this man's face, man.
Man, I am the boogeyman.
What is next to Terry?
No, I am the boogeyman. I am the boogeyman.
No,
I am the
boogeyman.
No, look at this. Old ass. Look at this goofy ass nigga Errol Spence percent of knockout, man. That nigga ain't never been scared of no nigga, man. I can't believe you niggas playing on this nigga like that, man. The way you niggas coming out, man, y'all should be ashamed of y'all damn self, man. Playing like Errol Spence scared or something. Like everybody on the hunt. Nigga, the hunter can't be hunted, nigga. He can't be hunted, bro. The nigga ain't scared of none of these dudes, man. But it is what it is, man. I hear everything motherfuckers saying right now. I just want to let niggas know that this nigga ain't never ducked no smoke. I believe him and Terrence Crawford in negotiations. So Terrence Crawford coming out saying little shit. That's why he came out with the, you know, with the ocean and shit, saying he looking for Spence. You know what I'm saying? And then now he talking this 35%. Then he said something to the IBF like he want to be mandatory. He saying this little shit. That shit don't mean shit. He saying everything but the right shit we want to hear. You know what I'm saying? That shit cooling off for promotion. That's why I look at it like, I look at that shit like promotion. That's why I don't really trip off of it. Like that shit like, you know, he just promote. That's why I say he keeping his fans happy right now. You know what I'm saying? He promoting, but I think these niggas in negotiations, obviously. You know what I'm saying? Everything is pointing toward negotiations. Errol Spence, Jaron Ennis said he ain't gonna step aside, but sorry, my bro, you gonna have to. Because this some shit everybody want. You know what I'm saying? Ain't no ducking Jaron Ennis because this shit was already in the play. You know what I'm saying? Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford was supposed to happen. These guys the biggest in the division, and it's time for them to lock horns. After that, then Jaron Ennis can go come get some smoke after that. You know what I'm saying? He can come get some whatever the smoke he want after that. But until then, you know what I'm saying? They gotta fight first. Let these guys finish doing what they doing. You know what I'm saying? Working out the deal behind the scenes and shit like that. Errol Spence, the deal get made, fuck around, get made before the year out. They fight, you know what I'm saying, the next few months, maybe February, March, like Errol Spence said. He just said this shit. It's like niggas don't be listening to him, or they don't want to listen to him. That's what I think. They don't want to hear him. He already came out and said,
"I'm the boogeyman. I'm the dog of the division.
I'm the dog of the division. I'm the boogeyman.
You can't be the boogeyman if I'm chasing."
He already said that he ready to fight. You know what I'm saying? He good. He was already, you know what I'm saying? He was already good. He was just waiting on the shit that, so he won't get punched. And I've been seeing the nigga in the gym with Derrick James. He's in super shape. I seen him at the last couple of events. The nigga in shape. He ready to go. But he ready to go too. So let these niggas figure that shit out in the negotiation. They made their fight. Jaron Ennis, you come out after that. I ain't worried about Keith Thurman. You know, Keith Thurman, a hoe. I should do this video. Matter of fact, I'm gonna do, I gotta do another video on him. This nigga fighting motherfucking Mario Barrio. Nigga, ain't this some motherfucking shit, nigga. If that ain't the most, I'm gonna get on that. But yeah, man, Jaron Ennis can get that smoke after these niggas lock horn. Let these niggas fight real quick, bro. Yeah, you go get toe smoke. But Jaron Ennis is a super dog. He don't give a fuck about none of this shit these niggas got going on. But he can't stop this shit. This shit already in the play, man. You know what I'm saying? shit already in the play. But it is what it is. Y'all hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, you're subscribed already. And I'm out, y'all. Deuces.